I modeled out what a profit and loss would look like for the next 3 years if two companies merge. How do I add a balance sheet? In order to add a balance sheet, you have to have certain assumptions. So a balance sheet doesn't have income and expenses. Those are for profit and loss. A balance sheet has assets, liabilities, and equity. So an example of some things that are on a balance sheet include accounts receivable. If the company has inventory, then it would include how much is in inventory. If there are liabilities, accounts payable or credit card liabilities or a bank loan. Those are some things that you would see on a balance sheet. And in order to forecast a balance sheet into the future of these two combined, these two merged companies, you have to make certain assumptions. So first of all, you take the existing balance sheets, add them up and say, okay, this is our merged balance sheet as of today. Then you make some assumptions, like what are, for example, average days in accounts receivable? And there's a formula that you can look up to then model out what future accounts receivable dollars will be on the balance sheet according to sales and previous AR and your assumption for the number of days in accounts receivable. That's what I meant when I say AR. Similarly, there's a ratio called days in inventory or days in inventory. Should be called like days getting dusty on the shelf should really be the name of this ratio. But if you make an assumption, let's say 15 days or 5 days or 30 days or 45 days, you enter in that assumption and then in your balance sheet, you have a formula that references that cell and it references that number and it references the cost of goods sold and maybe prior inventory. I would have to look it up. But there's a formula that will then, based on that information, project or forecast what future inventory dollars will be. Similarly, you consider, let's jump to the liability side. The average days that it's going to take to pay your payables. You make an assumption. It could be based on future plans. If your future plans involve better vendor relations than currently, then maybe you want to reduce the number of days that's currently taking for companies to pay their vendors. If you want to stretch it out and keep as much cash in house as possible, then raise the number of days in accounts payable. Either way, you put in a number and then in accounts payable, you put in a formula that references that number and cost of goods sold and whatever else is going through accounts payable. When it comes to debt, consider what management's plans are. Is there an amortization schedule for the debt? Fine. Enter that, put in that amortization schedule and plug in a formula that shows you how much the principal balance is going to be at the end of every year. We said for the next 3 years. Just put in a formula that references that amortization schedule for the next 3 years. So you can really do this based on formulas. And if you also want to include an indirect statement of cash flows, all you really have to do is put together the statement of cash flows and for the formulas, just add or subtract balance sheet balances from each other. When it comes to assets, it's the prior period minus the current period. That change gives you your figure for the statement of cash flow. And for liabilities, it's the opposite. Figure out, talk to management, or if you are management, consider whether you're going to have any material movement in property, plant, and equipment. Are you going to buy a warehouse? Are you going to buy a building? Are you going to sell a building? And take these things into account in these future financials by entering them in as formulas. We're going to sell the building and we think we're going to make X, or we're going to buy a $500,000 piece of equipment once our two companies merge. Okay, fine. Enter that in there as a formula and make sure the balance sheet picks up on it and the statement of cash flows picks up on that change. So that's my rundown on that. And by the way, how these can all link together is you have your cash balance on your balance sheet be linked to the ending cash balance on your statement of cash flows that calculates, at the bottom of the statement of cash flows, it says ending cash balance or cash end of period. That number, which is calculated, is going to be picked up by the balance sheet where it says cash or cash and cash equivalents. So even if you don't need to present a statement of cash flows to someone, It's always a good idea to produce one internally to be able to forecast your cash balances on the balance sheet.